Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended interviews for the movie Bad Santa 2. They're serving alcohol at this thing, but I'm a good Harkins theater goer. I wait till it's at least 5 o'clock, and it's not right now. You know, it's interesting because about 13 years ago, a big, raunchy film starring Oscar winner Billy Bob Thornton hit theaters. It's called Bad Santa. And for years, he couldn't go places without some fans saying, "When are you making a sequel?" Well, guess what? It's done. And it hits theaters this weekend, Bad Santa 2, and Harkins Theater sat down with the cast.
We got a job. I'm talking millions this time. Can you still crack a safe?
Did this character grow in any way in 13 years? I couldn't find much.
Yeah?
Was there any growth?
His beard.
Besides facial hair.
Well, actually, you know, there's a little bit more motion in this one than there was in the first one. I think it's a little more obvious that at the end of the day, he was just an abused kid who kind of sees himself in Thurman, you know what I mean? And I think that's clearer in this one. Yeah, I think in my mind he did grow some. He's still pretty intolerant of people. I think Willie's just one of those guys who doesn't tolerate stupidity.
Or really anything, for
much,
that matter.
Much of anything, yeah.
Arizonans will be thrilled to know that when we start it's the film, you're in Arizona.
Oh, yeah.
And you're in probably the worst apartment I've ever seen in Arizona. What was the worst apartment you actually ever lived in?
My first apartment in L.A. wasn't exactly what you'd call a dandy. It was one room. It was a converted motel. And so it was essentially a motel room. And you also paid by the week, if that gives you any idea.
Yeah.
So, it was...
Do you ever go by it now? Have you ever seen it since?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I go by it all the time, yeah. It did have one of those little short refrigerators, but no kitchen, no stove. Of course, I didn't have any money to buy food anyway, so it didn't really matter, did it?
Come on in, fellas.
What's up?
Have you been drinking?
They describe your character as a woman with a heart of gold and a libido of steel. How would you describe her?
I guess that's a good way to put it. Libido of steel. She's got a libido.
Yeah, she does.
She doesn't hold back.
No,
that's
she does
for
not.
Sure.
What are those scenes like to shoot? I mean, there are things you cannot unsee.
That's what I keep telling my family. I say, I'd love you to come, but you can't unsee what you've seen. They're hilarious. I mean, we're just completely going for it, and it's over the top, and it's raunchy, and it's just, it's a blast, to be honest. When you get to work with someone like Billy, and he was so open and welcoming, the very first scene we ever did was having sex in a Christmas tree lot. Mm-hmm. So it was an icebreaker, and we just said, go for it.
I get my Christmas trees from Frank Camasso on Hayden and Phoenix, and I almost feel like Frank needs to see this. I'm nervous now for Frank's little Christmas tree lot.
Frank's gonna have extra security after he sees this movie. He's gonna make sure that he knows what's going on every corner of his Christmas tree lot.
I didn't even know you had a mom.
Tattoos. Was there meaning behind them? How long did it take? And did you design any of them?
You know, Mike Mikash, I was working on American Horror Story, and we were shooting up in Montreal, so there was a lot of conversation going back and forth, and photos, and decisions being made. But he actually created those for us, the snake and the... I wanted a blue scorpion, you know, and I don't know where I got these things, but I want a blue scorpion, like I was the first one to ever think of it. And they're, you know, blue scorpion tattoos forever. And I just wanted her to be an old biker chick. You know, I wanted them to be faded, and they did a great job.
There is nothing that you don't say. There's nothing you don't do. There's not a noise you don't make. I mean, it's just so much. Is there anything in a film like this that doesn't make it in because it actually is too much?
Well, you'd have to ask the director that. I know that Tony Cox and I got into, there's more to the fight that's there. Let's just say that.
Great.
So we got into some very un-PC language with each other, which may end up on the final, you know, if you could buy the DVD or something, because we were kind of disappointed, but it may have been pushing the envelope a little too much for the producers.
I just wanted to invite you to the Christmas concert tomorrow, Willie. I'm singing in the choir.
When I got the call, I think I was outside in my underwear getting the mail.
Wait, that seems like a whole other story.
Yeah, let's gloss over that part.
I was just ready. 13 years have been long enough, and I was just, let's do this.
I actually do want to go back to not wearing a lot of clothes outside, because in the film, I'm from Arizona, and we do have this habit sometimes of showing up in Chicago in flip-flops, and we haven't really thought through what we're supposed to bring to colder climates. But you were in practically nothing. How cold actually was it?
I think the warmest it was minus 20. Oh. And the coldest it got was minus 37.
And I don't think I saw you shiver once.
Oh, that's, once they cut, you see the people swarming in with the parkas and the jackets and throwing me into a van.
Cash only, $10 or more, hundreds or better.
Look at those cheeks.
That's the ugliest baby on the planet.
I think we've always wanted to work together, and I've always admired him, he's unique. His unique sense of humor and his honesty. And I remember him saying to me a long time ago, we saw each other at some awards thing, and he said, Hollywood's weird. Because we're both sort of from the same neck of the woods. I said, yeah, it's weird. You know?
It's funny, I remember the first time interviewing him, I was nervous. You know, you read about him and he's very cerebral, he's very smart. Yeah. So you get nervous talking to him, and he's a softie, I think, at the end of the day.
Yeah, he's a good man, he's a righteous dude.
You guys make a great mother-son team.
Oh, thank you.
We need therapy after this movie.
What can I do for you?
Will you be able to find me at my grandma's house in Grand Rapids?
There's that iconic scene, and we see it again. Santa has the kids coming through, and then they've all got wish lists that are, you know, some are super long and some are ridiculous. And do you remember the first present as a kid that you ever got really excited about wanting for the holidays?
They had a Tiger tank, military tank that was big. It was like that long, you know, and they advertised that it was so powerful that you could actually ride on it.
Really?
Yeah, and they were right.
So you got it.
Yeah, I did get that. I mean, when I was growing up, that was a real popular thing for boys, to get toy soldiers and tanks and stuff like that. And that's the first one that I remember just coveting, you know, and we didn't get a lot for Christmas. I remember when I was in high school, we had a $15 limit.
Oh, wow.
My brothers and I, there were three of us, and we would look in the catalog, you know, the Sears catalog or Alden's or Montgomery Ward, whichever one it was, and you could pick out $15 worth. And of course, you know, then $15 was a lot more than it is now, but that was it. So you could usually get three pretty decent things.
Yeah. Do you give your kids a limit?
No, I'm a softie. I'm a complete idiot. I just let them get whatever they want. It's ridiculous.
For me, it was a wagon, a little red wagon.
I remember those.
Yeah.
Did you get it?
Yes.
Little red wagon. I think mine was like a PlayStation or something. So something with some kind of plug coming out of it.
What are you looking at me so funny for?
Sorry, Santa. I had to go.
A friend of mine, not me, but a friend of mine, years and years and years ago, had to be a Santa to make a living. And he said there was a little boy who sat on his lap and pissed on him and said, "This is for the electric train you didn't give me last year."
Oh, he did not.
Yeah, oh, he did.
How old was this kid?
I don't know, but Bob was like, "What?"
I'm dreading seeing that kid now. Like, I don't know what that kid is like dealing with defeat now. That's almost scary.
I don't remember ever sitting on a Santa's lap, and I don't have any photos of it.
Did it happen?
I don't know if it ever happened. Maybe my parents never took me to sit on Santa's lap.
Maybe they didn't.
But I have now.
Yeah, I'm sure you have.
I've made up for it.
More than once in the Christmas tree lot.
Exactly.
And other places.
And other places.
That are very unique.
The first gift that I got so excited about, I got leg warmers and leotards because I wanted to be in fame. And I was really little, and I wore the leg warmers and the leotard everywhere I went.
You seem very low maintenance. I like the request of, you know, nowadays kids are like, I want the iPad, I want this and this and this, and you just wanted your leg warmers.
I was like, I just want a pair of leg warmers. That's all I want.
Did you talk like that?
Yeah, I was like from Oliver Twist. It was very strange in my house.
What do you request for this holiday season? What's on your Christmas wish list from Santa?
Just for this movie to do really, really well, and let everybody just get along and have a good time.
Warm weather. That's all I need at this point.
I want Minecraft, Halo 5 Guardians, Rise of the Tomb.
I don't know.
Call of Duty, Black
Ops, I don't know what you're talking about. You could be speaking Swahili and I wouldn't know any better.
Grand Theft Auto 5.
Nah, I don't care.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for Bad Santa 2. Again, a big warning, this is rated R for so many reasons. So many reasons. That's all I'm saying. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And speaking of holiday gifts, the 2017 Harkins Loyalty Cup is out. You can buy it on the Harkins website or at any Harkins Theater. In fact, we've got kind of a cool theme on the cup this year, the cast of some films coming out in 2017.